In this segment, we'll talk about how do we multiply two matrices. So two matrices A and B can be multiplied as A times B, because we can have multiplication like B times A also, but limiting it to multiplied as A times B. Under what circumstances can we multiply B by A or multiply A by B is if the number of columns of A is same as number of rows of B. So only if the number of columns of A is same as the number of rows of B, only then it can be multiplied. So let's see what that means. So if I have my A matrix and I have M rows and P columns, so I got M rows and P columns of A, then if I have the B matrix, only if this one has P rows is this matrix multiplication defined. And then this can have any number of columns, N columns. So the number of columns of A has the same as the number of rows of B. And the resulting matrix, which we call as, let's suppose, the C matrix, will have this many rows and this many columns. So that's how we are at least able to say that whether the matrix multiplication is allowed. Now, how do we find out individual elements of the C matrix is given by a summation. So ijth element of C will be given by the summation k is equal to 1 to P, which is P is the number of columns of A or the number of rows of B, A I K B K J. So you want to find the ijth element. What you have to do is you have to take the I kth elements, where K ranges from 1 to P, then take the kjth element of B, K again ranges from 1 to P, and do this product, and then you add all of those products to be able to get Cij. So what that basically also means is that if we expand this, we'll get A I1 B 1J plus A I2 B 2J all the way up to A IP B PJ. So what you're able to see is that all of these elements which are taken off the A matrix, let's suppose, they are in the ith row, but the column number is changing. And then the elements which are taken from the B are all in the jth column, and the row number is changing. So that's how you would find out what the Cij element will be. This can be also viewed as that, as if we are taking, as we just said, that hey, we're taking the ith row of A, and then we are looking at the jth column of B. So we could be saying that, hey, Cij is that we take the A in the row, the ith row, AI1 all the way up to AIP. And then what we're going to do is we're going to multiply by a column of the B matrix, which will be the jth column. So B1J all the way up to BPJ. So we're taking the ith row of A and taking the jth row of B, and we're going to find this product. So again, what we're finding out, this is one row and P columns, and this one is P rows and one column, and this will result in a 1 by 1 matrix, which is a scalar, and that's the one which will be corresponding to the Cijth element. So you can either view it as this summation right here, or you can look at it as a dot product of these two vectors. And that's the end of this segment.